Hello everyone, today we want to explore Streamlit. We want to build a simple chat application with LangChain and the OpenAI API. Also we want another tab with the usage graph, so here the cost in US dollar for the tokens that we used will be displayed. At the end, I want to talk about the advantages and disadvantages of this framework. So if you're interested to see how to build such a chat application with Streamlit in a very short amount of time, then keep watching. Okay, let's look at the Streamlit website and let's understand the main concepts. You can run your app with Streamlit run and then the name of the Python file. So while developing, you will have the website already open. And if you make a change in the code and save the file, then you can rerun the website and directly see the change. Here's a very important point, the data flow. Every time something on the screen has to be updated, Streamlit will rerun the entire Python code and render everything again. In the example at the beginning, with the chat displayed there in a normal website with JavaScript, everything would be rendered client-side, so in your web browser, and you would have your chat, new elements would appear while continuing to chatting. But here, the previous chat elements would disappear since the script has to rerun. So we have to program a mechanism which will be here the session state. Also, if there are functions which have a lot of computation or something, you can cache the data so that they don't rerun each time, especially in Python, which is kind of slow. This would take a lot of time, so the user has to wait way too long. But we don't have big computations here, so in our case, it's going to be relatively fast. Okay, some interesting things you can do. If you just write something without a print statement, just an expression, it will print it into the Streamlit app. Yeah, so let's actually do it. And obviously, we have to install some requirements. In our case, we need LangChain, Streamlit, Python.env, OpenAI, SD chat message. This is a component. The community can create their own components, and this will just make the chat messaging a little bit simpler for us. So we have to install it as well. And pandas. I have here an OpenAI token usage CSV file, so I can keep track of the usage every time I run the LLM or LLM chain. Let's display it. Okay, and here directly we have the pandas data frame displayed, simply like that. The underlying mechanism is that it will call the streamlit.write function. And there are many more things. You can create tables, you can create charts. Let's actually do it. Let's see, always rerun. And there we have it. It's just simply one line and you can already display some charts, some data frames, tables, whatever you want. It's that easy. There's also the possibility to work with multiple pages and with tabs on every page. So we're going to work with tabs. And there are different elements, sidebars, columns, containers, whatever. Let's take the tab simply like that. Tab 1 and tab 2. Just want the chat tab and the usage chart tab. We can use every tab like this. And there we have it. Okay, let's go to the API reference. Let's add some more stuff. st.title, simple LangChain chat app. And we can also add some icons. Okay. And let's add a header for every tab. Okay, perfect. Now let's go to the actual chatbot part. Let's create a utilities file. Create the chat app here because I don't want the code to be messy in the app file. Definitely want to outsource the code in another Python file. We need load.env for the API key, obviously, and from LangChain, the LLM chain, chat.mai, conversation buffer, and prompt template. So let's make a function. Get the template. We want to add the chat history and the human input. So the template is going to be. We need the memory, conversation buffer, memory key. Then we can actually create a chain. And we also want to have the verbose set to true so you can see the output, what's happening. Okay. Import utils. Chain. Create the LangChain. Oh, obviously I need a .env file with the OpenAI key.
Using the port from SD, chat, message, import message.
To get user message input, yeah, just here in the API reference, chat elements, and chat input.
Just simply user message.chat input, make inside the placeholder.
If user message, we want to check if the user inputted something, then we can run the chain.
We need human input.
And now we can run message from user message, and then the output message is user's fault. Let's see.
What's my name?
Here we have the first problem. We don't have the chat history here. And also, as we read before, the script will be run again if there is a user input or something has to change on the site. Therefore, we will again run the create LLM chain, and the chain won't have the history. So here's the complicated part with this framework. We now have to create a method to persist everything in the session state. Let's look at it. Session state management. You simply initialize everything by checking if there is something already in the session state, and if not, you can instantiate it with a key value pair. So we have to do two things. We need to persist the LLM chain so it keeps the memory, and we also need to save the session state for the messages. Okay, let's start with the chain.
If LLM chain. Not in session state, session state.lm.
You can put the key in brackets or also, yeah, just with a dot. Okay, and we want to just create it here. And if we run, if we're going to run it, we just run it from the state. Now it's going to have the memory. Now we want to add the chat history. If messages not in state, then we want to add it as a list. Okay, and we want to create a function to append the messages to the state and want to restore the chat in the UI.
Append messages?
The user message and also the bot message. And we want to append it as a dictionary, user message and bot message. Okay, now we want to restore the history messages. So for every message in the session state, we want to create... Ah, wait a minute.
History message.
Okay, so every history message, we want to create a message object, user message and a bot message. We also have to give a key. I ran into the error that there were some problems, because if we don't provide keys, then there's going to be an error because they will share the same key and there can't be multiple widgets with the same key instantiated. So therefore we have to set the key. Let's also set them here. And here we want to set the key to something that's unique, and for that we're going to take the datetime, put it into a string, datetime.now. Here the same thing. If the user message is called, we want to first restore the history messages, because we want to have the history messages first, and then the new messages should be the last messages. Also, we need to obviously call it append messages here at the end. Let's call it append state messages. We should have everything set up. Now let's talk about the post tracking. We can track the token usage here in LangChain. Just have to import the OpenAI callback. And every time we call a model, call a chain, we can just put it with get OpenAI callback SCB. Let's create an actual logging function here in the utils file. And I have here the timestamp in a German format, the total tokens, the prompt tokens, completion tokens, total cost, and also the US date format. The log function takes as arguments those
tokens, the prompt tokens, the completion tokens, and also the total cost.
So with open OpenAI usage as file, how this works, if you would open it by itself and then write something into it, then you would have to close it also. And if you put something into the with statement, everything that is happening within the with statement is happening in there, then the file automatically gets closed. Okay, and we also want the datetime.
Datetime? No.
String format time. Day, month, and year, white space, hour, seconds. We also want the English date time. Perfect. So okay, we also want to change the line chart to a bar chart. And here, that's also really interesting. There's every single instance in the bar. And there we have it, history will be displayed. Also the usage is tracked, that we have the new instance. As simple as that. Okay, the conclusion. I think it's pretty cool, it's very straightforward. You can very simply, in a very short amount of time, code something like this. If you don't have any experience with HTML and JavaScript, this might be your go-to solution. I mean, it's easy, it's fast, it's high level. You don't have to understand the underlying mechanics. Especially, I think it's especially useful if you have some simple data, some tables, some charts, something you want to visualize. You can really simply display it here in the front end on a web page. I think that's very amazing. Also considering deployment, you can deploy on their website, on their community Unity Hub, that's also a nice feature. The disadvantage is definitely that the script reruns every time something changes. Again, Python is not the fastest language, and if you have some functions here which are computation heavy or will take a lot more time, then your user will have to wait a very long time to have the interface loaded. So that's not very nice. You can circumvent it a little bit by caching. Let's say you have a function which takes two variables. The first time you open the site, the function obviously will have to run and compute everything. If the site gets run again, but the function parameters are the same, then there comes the caching in and the function will not be run again. Therefore, you can save time. If you have functions which don't change a lot, that's okay. But if there are computation heavy functions which are changing a lot, which get a lot of new parameters every time, yeah, that might be some overhead that will slow down your site. All in all, if you want to develop a really simple application and don't want to waste a lot of time for the front-end development, yeah, you can use Streamlit. The documentation, the API reference is really easy to understand. You have every element here, just click on it, there's a good example how it works. So very straightforward everything, very short development time. So all in all, I like it. Try it out yourself, let me know what you think. I will upload this code on a GitHub repository so you can download it if you want. So we laid the foundation here. My next video will be on summarization of YouTube videos and web articles. We will put everything in a Streamlit app and then deploy it on the AWS, Amazon Web Services. So that's going to be interesting. I hope you liked this video. Thank you for watching. Click the like button, click the subscribe button, and see you in the next video.